بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today we will discuss hemostasis. Hemostasis, this is the process by which blood clots form at sites of vascular injury. Hemostasis is a precisely orchestrated process involving platelets, clotting factors, and endothelium that occurs at the site of vascular injury and culminates in the formation of a blood clot. This blood clot serves to prevent or limit the extent of bleeding. Now, normally there is a hemostatic balance from Almighty Allah. We need, our blood should remain fluid, this should circulate in the vessels. Now, whenever there is some injury, some trauma, there is bleeding. Now, there should be some arrangement to stop this bleeding. So all these things are provided in our plasma, in our blood. Normally there is hemostatic balance. There are some proteins which are prothrombotic, which try to promote thrombosis or clotting. There are other proteins, other substances which are antithrombotic, which inhibit this clotting. Both these are very necessary for normal life. Normally there is a hemostatic balance. Whenever there is trauma, there is clot formation to stop this bleeding, and normally these antithrombotic protein, these factors, they maintain the blood as fluid. Or there are some deviations from this normal behavior, so the balance can be shifted to this side or this side. So if antithrombotic proteins are more active, then there may be bleeding tendency or hemorrhagic disorders. If prothrombotic factors are more active, there may be a thrombotic tendency, thrombus formation. Another third possibility, that is disseminated intravascular coagulation. We will discuss this with detail. The formation of microthrombi, this utilizes the platelets and coagulation factors. So there is a thrombotic tendency, but there is also bleeding tendency. So we will be discussing these things. But before this, you must know what is the normal physiological process of hemostasis. Now see this slide. This is bone marrow slide. We aspirate the marrow, we can stain this by Jimza or Leishman stain, just like a peripheral blood. And these big cells, these are the megakaryocytes. The megakaryocyte, this is the largest cell in the bone marrow. This is containing a very big nucleus and lot of cytoplasm. So from the cytoplasm of the megakaryocytes, small fragments, these are removed and these are sent to the circulation. These are the platelets. So platelets are not a complete cell. Platelets are just small fragments, small pieces from the cytoplasm of a big cell, megakaryocyte, that normally stays in the bone marrow. This will not come in the peripheral blood. Now see this slide. You can see the red cells, and in between you can see smaller than these red cells. These are the platelets, maybe one third, one fourth of a red cell. These are the platelets, small fragments from these cytoplasm of the megakaryocytes. So these are very important for hemostasis. Now, to understand this normal process of hemostasis, you must understand this picture in your book from Robbins. Very important picture. If you have proper understanding of this picture, then you will be clear how this hemostasis takes place. Now you can see in this picture, this is a vessel wall. The inner side of the vessel wall, this is lined by the endothelial cells. Then under this endothelium, there is subendothelium. You can see this in this picture. This subendothelium, this is continuous, but these two endothelial cells, these have a space in between. There is some trauma. Due to this trauma, this endothelial injury, the subendothelial structures are exposed to the blood circulating in the vessel wall. Now in this picture you can see this von Willebrand factor. So due to trauma, normally this is covered by the endothelial cells. After trauma, this subendothelial structures are exposed. Now you can see this von Willebrand factor, this is combining with a protein that is present on the surface of the platelets. This protein is GP1B. This is attached with the platelet surface, GP1B. This is combining with the von Willebrand factor. So both these things are important for adhesion of platelets. If the von Willebrand factor is deficient, this will result in a bleeding tendency. Disease is known as von Willebrand disease, deficiency of von Willebrand factor. And this is most common after factor 8 deficiency in coagulation factors. Von Willebrand disease, this is the most common clinical problem. Patients have a bleeding tendency. If this GP1B, this receptor on the platelet surface, this protein is deficient, so deficiency of GP1B, this again will result in a bleeding tendency, and the disease is known as Bernard-Soulier syndrome. So this is one of the functional platelet defects. The platelet count may be normal, but this is not functioning properly due to deficiency of this protein, GP1B. These receptors are not available, so platelets cannot have a proper adhesion with the von Willebrand factor. So there is a bleeding tendency. This disease is known as deficiency of GP1B. This results in a disease that is named as Bernard-Soulier syndrome. Now another thing you can see in this picture, the three platelets, these are combining to each other through some molecule, bluish colored molecule. This is fibrinogen. Three molecules of fibrinogen you can see between these three platelets. These are attached to each other. Two rows of these molecules you can see fibrinogen. But this fibrinogen will attach to the platelets in the presence of another protein. There is another receptor on the platelet surface. That protein is known as GP2B, 3A complex, GP2B 3A complex. So attachment of platelets with other platelets, this is known as aggregation of platelets. Attachment of platelets with non-platelet surfaces, this is known as adhesion of platelets. So if von Willebrand factor is deficient or GP1B, this receptor, this protein is deficient, so this will result in defective adhesion of platelets. And this can, we can see this in Bernard's Ollier syndrome, or we can see this in von Willebrand disease. If this GP2B3A complex, this receptor, this protein is deficient, this will result again in bleeding tendency. The disease is known as Glanzmann thrombasthenia. Glanzmann thrombasthenia. So if this receptor, this protein is deficient, there will be defective aggregation of the platelets. So all these things are needed for normal adhesion, normal aggregation of platelets, then there will be proper hemostasis. Now keeping all these things in mind, these terms will be used in hemostasis, then you will be in a better position to understand the normal hemostatic process. What happens after trauma? Initially there will be arteriolar vasoconstriction. This will happen immediately. This will markedly reduce the blood flow to the injured area. This is a reflex neurogenic mechanism, and there is some secretion of some local factors such as endothelin. This endothelin, this is a potent endothelin derived vasoconstrictor. So this will result in vasoconstriction. But this is a transient effect, short-lived effect. Then primary hemostasis, the formation of platelet plug. There is disruption of the endothelium. This means there is some trauma to the endothelium. This will expose the subendothelial von Willebrand factor and collagen. You have seen this picture before. I have explained this. After trauma, the subendothelial structures are exposed. This will promote platelet adherence and activation, because the von Willebrand factor will attach to the receptors on the platelets through the GP1B. I have shown you this picture before. Then there is a shape change of the platelets. The shape of the platelets from small rounded disc, this is changed to some flat plates with spiky protrusions. So simply the platelets, they have an increased surface area. Then there is a release reaction. There are some granules within the platelets, alpha granules, delta granules. These are ruptured and these will release their contents. And the released contents, they have different effects. Within minutes, the secreted products recruit additional platelets. Now they will attract more and more platelets. You have seen the picture before. The platelets are attached to other platelets through fibrinogen molecules, through receptors of GP2B3A complex. So this attachment of platelets to the other platelets This is known as aggregation. So platelets will undergo aggregation to form a primary hemostatic plug. So temporarily this will stop the bleeding. This is a very fragile plug. Then there is secondary hemostasis, deposition of fibrin. So from a tissue factor, membrane bound procoagulant glycoprotein expressed by the subendothelial cells in the vessel wall, such as smooth muscle cells and fibroblasts. So all these are subendothelial structure where there is trauma to the endothelial cells. They are just like one Willebrand's factor is exposed. So these factors are also exposed to the blood in the vessels. Now tissue factor binds and activates factor 7. So when factor, this is extensive pathway of coagulation, factor 7 is activated. This will result in thrombin generation. Thrombin has different effects. Thrombin cleaves circulating fibrinogen into insoluble fibrin. What is the final effect of this coagulation cascade? This may be started from the intrinsic pathway, this may be started from extrinsic pathway. Here this is starting from extrinsic pathway. Final result is the formation of fibrin from the fibrinogen, creating a fibrin mesh wall. So in aggregated platelets, there is deposition of fibrin threads. So this thrombin formation, this is also a potent activator of platelets. This will lead to additional platelet aggregation at the site of injury. This will recruit more and more platelets. So hemostatic plug is increasing in size, more and more platelet aggregation. There is deposition of fibrin threads. This sequence, this is referred to as second hemostasis. This consolidates the initial platelet plug. Then there is clot stabilization and resorption. Polymerized fibrin and platelet aggregates undergo contraction to form a solid permanent plug. So this stops the bleeding at the site of injury. Now this clot should not extend to other areas. There are some counter regulatory mechanisms like tissue plasminogen activator. This limits the clotting and eventually lead to clot resorption and tissue repair. So this is a normal process how hemostasis occurs. You can see this from these diagrams. This is from your book, Robbins. This is a vessel wall. You can see the endothelial cells, you can see basement membrane, arterial smooth muscles. Now on the lower side you can see the endothelial cells are not in continuity. They did some trauma, these are ruptured. So there is discontinuation in the layer of endothelial cells. At this site, so subendothelial structures are exposed. So there is release of endothelin from the injured endothelial cells. This causes vasoconstriction. You can see this blue colored arrow. the clot is going upside in the vessel wall. So this will reduce the caliber of the vessel wall. This will reduce the blood flow in that area. There is reflex vasoconstriction. There is release of endothelin. So all these factors will result in vasoconstriction at the site of injury. This will temporarily reduce the blood flow to that area. And this is a transient phenomenon we have discussed. But in the initial stage, this also helps in slowing the blood flow from the injured site. Then in primary hemostasis, picture B, lower side, you can see this. Different events. There is rupture of the endothelial cells. Basement membrane is exposed. Then von Willebrand factor. This is exposed to the circulating blood. Within the blood, von Willebrand factor will come in contact with the platelets. I have shown you the initial picture through the GP1B receptors on the platelets. So with this attachment, this is known as platelet adhesion. Attachment of platelets to some non-platelet surface. This is attaching to the von Willebrand factor. Now of this attachment, there is an event that is known as shape change. The platelets, they will release the granular contents, ATP, thrombectin, A2, other things. They will change the shape from rounded shape. They are becoming more flattened. They are increasing their surface area. Now, after this release reaction, there is recruitment of more and more platelets. This will attract more and more platelets to this area. Now, these platelets are combining. They are attaching to the other platelets. I have shown you the picture in initial stage. How these will combine? Through the fibrinogen molecule and due to the presence of GP2B3A complex, this receptor on the platelet surface. So attachment of this platelet to other platelets, this is known as aggregation of platelets. So due to this aggregate of platelets, this will form a temporary hemostatic plug. This will stop the bleeding, but this is very fragile. This can break any time. The bleeding can start again. Then next step, this is secondary hemostasis. You can see this picture. What happens? At the injured site, tissue factor is exposed. This is attached with the platelets. There is adhesion of platelets. There is aggregation of platelets. And there is deposition of fibrin threads. This blue colored thread in between the platelet, you can see this. Due to thrombin activation, fibrinogen is changed to fibrin threads. Then these fibrin threads, they polymerize and they deposit within the platelets. So this is some sort of cementing substance. This will make the platelet plug stable. Then next step, there is contraction of this platelet plug. The fibrin threads at platelet aggregates, these will contract and this will form a solid clot that will seal that injured area and then will stop the bleeding. Now there are some other factors. This clot or this thrombus should not propagate to other unwanted sites. This should remain to the injured site only. So there is release of some other factors. Release of tissue plasminogen activator. This results in fibrinolysis, extra thrombin threads are broken down into FDP, FSOP, fibrin degradation product, fibrin split product. This blocks the coagulation cascade. In this clot, you can see fibrin threads, maybe some entrapped neutrophils, maybe some trapped blood red cells. So all these may be present in this clot. So after retraction of this clot, which contains the fibrin threads, which contains the aggregates of platelets, which contains the entrapped neutrophil red cells and other things, after this retraction, so this is forming a stable plug that will seal the injured site and stop the bleeding. So this is normal hemostasis, normal physiological process of hemostasis. To understand the problems of this, what is thrombosis, what is bleeding tendency, you must know this normal process. Thank you.